Excellencies, I am happy to report that in a spirit of friendship and solidarity, and after great compromise on both sides, all of us have been able to resolve the last outstanding issue also. I'll ask Secretary Navtej Sarna to read the formulation. Navtej.
Thank you, Excellency. The group that met showed a tremendous spirit of compromise, and we thank each and every delegation for agreeing with this formulation. This formulation, which I will now read out, will replace the paragraph, the one line that is already there in the text. I will read out the following formulation on which there has been consensus. We recall and reaffirm the principles behind the fight against colonialism, xenophobia, apartheid, and violation of human rights, in which India and Africa fought together. End of formulation.
Thank you, Excellencies. Now there is agreement amongst all of us about the text of the two draft outcome documents. I see no objection now, and now the two documents are approved to be sent to the summit for consideration of the heads of state and government. Friends, I would also like to compliment all the officials who have worked over so many days and especially today for preparation of these documents. We are very grateful for all the help and assistance provided by our colleagues from the African Union Commission, which is led by the Deputy Chairperson at today's meeting. May I now invite the Deputy Chairperson of the African Union Commission, His Excellency Erastus Mwencha, to address this gathering. Yes.
Thank you very much, Co-Chair. Maybe before I make my statement, there is an announcement that is to be made from Secretariat of the Commission, and that is regarding the Ministerial Open-Ended Committee on International Criminal Court, which will take place tomorrow, Wednesday, the 28th October, and this meeting, and that is the meeting of Open-Ended Committee on International Criminal Court. The venue will be at the Ethiopian Embassy here in New Delhi, and the time is 15:30 hours, and the address for this, for those who may wish to get the address, please come to the Commission, we'll assist you, but the actual location is 7/50-Chi, Satya Mag, Chakanakaya, Puri, New Delhi. I thank you. Your Excellency, now that we have come to the end of this long, hardworking, and fruitful day, may I simply say, thank you, Excellency, Madam Sushma Swaraj, Minister of External Affairs of India, for co-chairing the meeting and for your patience and tenacity that you have demonstrated. Thank you, Excellency Simbarash Mubengengwe, Minister of Foreign Affairs of Zimbabwe, co-chair, who also has led us not only here but also in preparation for this meeting. For some time. Let me also convey appreciation to all Excellencies, Ministers of Foreign Affairs and other ministers present for your participation, statements that you've made which show your support and commitment to the India Africa Partnership. May I also use this opportunity to thank the Excellencies, the ambassadors, and senior officials for the excellent work that they did, which has made it possible for you to devote a lot of time in looking at principal issues because of the work that was done, and also all other colleagues who were involved in this exercise. But our coming here wouldn't have been possible without, of course, the support that we have enjoyed from our host country. And so let me, first of all, extend our heartfelt, profound appreciation to His Excellency, Mr. Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister, and Madam, you personally, and also the people of India, this great country, for the warm hospitality that has been extended to all of us, and excellent facilities put at the disposal of this meeting. Excellencies, we are happy to note that our meeting today was conducted in a very amicable and friendly manner, which resulted into our adopting the two outcome documents in preparation for the summit of our heads of state and government. In this regard, as we have said earlier, we thank the senior officials who tirelessly worked towards developing these documents. Excellencies, as a follow-up to the adoption of these documents, please allow me to highlight the following key points, which I hope could be used as additional input in mapping out our future cooperation. That principle simply says that multilateralism and bilateralism are not mutually exclusive. In fact, they reinforce each other, and not a zero-sum game. We say so to simply say it is important, therefore, in the future, that we look at how it's possible for us to concentrate on a few projects, but do them well. It is clear that from the partnership, we have quite a number of areas of convergence and areas that are of interest to both sides. But we know that we don't have the wherewithal to be able to address a wide array of activities. I'm saying this as a prelude to the fact that in the interventions that were made here, there was clear recognition on the need for us to have a mechanism that can be able to continue to follow up on what you have agreed on, and also to continue to evaluate how our partnership is moving forward. We hope and trust that on your part you'll be able to put in place that mechanism. I can assure you from the African side, this is already in place so that we can now continuously and vigorously monitor what you have agreed so that we can realize the benefits of this partnership for our people. We have also agreed to develop sound and clear mechanisms for that coordination, for that monitoring. This mechanism, which will be developed in 3 months' time, should contain clear indicators and priority, and also periodicity of monitoring and evaluation. In this regard, I wish to call upon the parties to immediately engage in the process of developing the said mechanism. Excellencies, finally, I would like to assure you of the African Union's commitment and readiness to materialize the outcomes of the Third African Forum Summit for the best interest of our people. With these few remarks, I wish to once again thank you so much, and the government and the people of India, for making this a great success that we have witnessed. Thank you, and may God bless you.
Thank you, Excellency. May I now invite our co-chair, His Excellency S.S. Mumbain Gagwe, the Foreign Minister of Zimbabwe, to make his closing remarks.
Thank you, co-chair. This has been a long day, and therefore I don't have many words to say except to thank you, co-chair, for your determination and tenacity, which has won the day. And I think it's a tribute to this partnership that we, as Africans, we're quite comfortable to show our differences with passion in front of our host. In other situations, we would have felt a little inhibited. But I think this demonstrates the closeness and the mutual trust and confidence that we have between us from Africa and our host in India. It clearly demonstrates that no chasm is unbridgeable. I'm sure when this discussion started, it appeared as if, especially the last discussion, it appeared as if it was absolutely impossible to find common ground. And indeed, we have found common ground, as we always do whenever issues come up. In this respect, it was our co-chair who has won the day, because as you were sitting here, she was saying to me, I am not taking any brackets to the heads of state. I'm not taking any brackets, no brackets. Yes, she was so determined, saying, no brackets, no brackets. We must agree, we must agree, and we will agree. And indeed, we did agree. So I, with those few words, I must thank you and congratulate you for the very excellent manner in which you have conducted in our business and our partnership. And of course, the documents that were adopted are going to guide us into very fruitful cooperation in the various areas of our political and economic activity. Madam Co-Chair, thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Co-Chair. Excellencies, it has been a privilege for me to have co-chaired this landmark ministerial meeting at the Third India-Africa Forum Summit, along with my distinguished colleague from Zimbabwe, representing the presidency of the African Union. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I once again thank you for your participation at today's meeting. Your participation has made this meeting a great success. I would also like to thank the interpreters for their excellent efforts. I would also like to thank all other people who have worked hard and made all the arrangements for our meeting today. May I now call the meeting to a close and invite you all for dinner later in the evening. We are all hungry, so reach straight to the hotel for dinner. Thank you.
Excellencies, ladies,